In Rome, pretty much what you see is what you get. Or do you?
Welcome to Italy!
Hello, this is Simone. Join me on my new adventures on A Road Through Traveled. This week's episode is brought to you by the official A Road Through Traveled app for your iPhone, iPad Touch, and iPad. For above 99, not only you support our efforts to bring you more quality travel shows, but you get extra features only available on the app, like travel tips, bonus footage, photos, and more. Just search for Road Through Traveled in the App Store and get yours today. Thank you, and happy travels! This episode includes a bonus feature only available on the app.
Can the great masters like Bernini fool your eyes while fascinating them with grandiose architecture and masterful brushstrokes? Take the colossal colonnade, for example. 284 columns long, 4 columns deep. But if you stand on one specific spot in the piazza marked by a white disc, it creates the illusion that there's only one row of columns, not four. Next time you're in St. Peter's Piazza, see for yourself. But the piazza is not the only place that tricks your eye. Follow me into the basilica itself. On the floor surrounding the baldacchino are a series of marble designs using a mirror effect of unique natural patterns found inside the marble slabs. This Renaissance version of the Rorschach effect creates images suggestive of religious figures. Can you see the mysterious images so cleverly hidden in a natural marble? Like this cardinal, for example? There's even more marble illusion.
Here's a bit of a secret that you'll see in a lot of churches in Italy, in fact, even most of them, including St. Peter's, because marble is not always easy to come by, especially in like huge sizes. If you notice the gray marble, especially in the pillars in St. Peter's, and they look like marble, but it's actually paint. It's been faux painted to look like marble, and you'll see this in many churches throughout Italy. I was just surprised to see it here in St. Peter's as well.
St. Peter's is not the only church that fools you into thinking some of the marble is real. Even in churches outside of Rome, you can find faux marble, like inside the San Rufino Cathedral in Assisi. And the Santa Maria Sopra Minerva, also in Assisi. But the faux marble is not the only attempt to fool your eye. The Church of San Inizio in Rome has an elaborately decorated dome. But wait, is that a real dome or flat ceiling? Can you tell the difference? This is not the only optical illusion cupola. In a Vatican Museum's round room, the dome is trompe l'oeil to look like the Pantheon. Not to be outdone, the small Chiesa Nuova Church, also in Assisi, created its own faux coffers, also inspired by the ancient Pantheon. If you can make it, fake it! Even from far away, St. Peter's will play tricks on you. From Via Niccolo Piccolomini on Gianicolum Hill, you'll discover a splendid illusion. Once you turn onto the street, you'll notice St. Peter's Dome, and it looks real close up like it's right smack at the end of the road, but it seems to play hard to get because the closer to the end of the road you get, the farther away the dome gets. I tried this on the back of a scooter while scooting through Rome with tour guide Dennis Pussolini. I was so amazed by it, we drove by again. It's even more spectacular when you see it for yourself in person. And when you are at the end of the street, make sure you stop to admire the view, which by now appears even smaller. And this trompe-l'oeil did not require the magic of a paintbrush or chisel. On top of Elephantine Hill is a keyhole that turns even the most unassuming people and nuns into peeping toms. Via di Santa Sabina opens onto the quiet Piazza of the Knights of Malta, where you'll find a high wall with a famous wooden door. Here, you don't take a key to the keyhole, just your eyeball. And what you'll see is a fairy tale, misty version of St. Peter's Dome in perfect perspective and elegantly framed by archway of trees from the garden beyond the door. Taking a photo through the keyhole does not give it justice. It's really meant to be experienced through the naked eye, not a camera lens. Here's something else to consider as you're spying at St. Peter's through the keyhole. You're seeing three countries at once. You're standing in Italy, looking through the Knights of Malta land, and seeing the Vatican. But that's open for debates, and some say the sovereignty of the Sovereign Military Order of Malta is not internationally recognized. Minor details. And the Knights of Malta is a religious organization that provides humanitarian and medical assistance worldwide. But you may not be able to tell by the military guy standing outside. Sovereign order that's not sovereign? Knights that carry guns and drive military jeeps? Military order that's really a religious organization? That's no trompe-l'oeil, but it sure does play tricks on the brain. Another hill that I'd like to show you is Intestaccio, at the bottom of Aventine Hill. This is not one of the seven famous hills that ancient Rome was built upon, but one that was built by the Romans. This is not so much Mount Testaccio as it is Mount Trashmore, with ancient trash that is, a hill of broken pots. A massive dump site for primarily empty, unrecyclable 15-gallon jugs that carried olive oil imported primarily from Spain. To get to Testaccio, catch the red metro line to the Piramide stop. Yes, there is a pyramid in Rome, and no, it's not another optical illusion. We'll see more of that pyramid in a future show. Trompe-l'oeil may be a French word that means to fool the eye, but they sure know how to do it in Rome. Thank you for joining me today in the Eternal City. If you find something that fools your eye in your travels, be sure to let me know. Until next time, ciao for now!